In this video tutorial, we are going to cover the most common Angular questions that you may have, and on top of that, we are going to even build the first Angular application. Before we start creating our first Angular application, let's first go through some theory so that you have the basic understanding of Angular, what it is, what it does, what are the prerequisites, what are the features, how to use it, etc. So first question that most likely you are going to have is, what is Angular? So by definition, it's a development platform built on TypeScript that will give you the ability to develop large applications in a maintainable manner. So for now, let's just remember that, and later on, things will get more clear for you because we are going to deep dive into some other details that will clarify this further. But for now, just remember that with Angular, you can build pretty much anything from small to the large enterprise applications. So since it is built on the TypeScript, now you may ask, so what is TypeScript? So TypeScript, it is strongly typed programming language that builds on JavaScript, but it is giving you better tooling at scale. So now, the thing is that with JavaScript, we are not able to strictly define most of the things, and we do not have the ability to easily identify the bugs and the issues in the code. The interesting thing is that most companies, when they try to switch their existing JavaScript project to a TypeScript project, they will find a lot of the bugs that they didn't even know that they have. So some of the TypeScript benefits are cleaner code, less bug, faster debugging, etc. So let's now talk about some of the Angular features. One of them is custom components, which means that we have the ability to easily create small components or even a big one for our project and then reuse that same component in the different parts of the big project. The next one is data binding, which means that we have the ability to easily move the data from the JavaScript code to the view, and in that way we are actually able to easily get interaction and the data from the user input back into the JavaScript code. The next one is dependency injection, which means that we can easily create services and then use them in the different part of our project. Also, we have the ability to do testing, which means that we can easily write both unit tests, integration tests, and by doing that, we can easily like future-proof our project to make sure it always like bug-free. Angular is also comprehensive, which means that it's going to provide you all the tooling that you might need, both from the routing, talking with the backend, etc., etc. And at the end, we have the browser compatibility, which means that pretty much Angular will work in any modern browser, so you don't have to worry about that. Now that we know the basics about Angular, let's talk about some of the Angular prerequisites. So those are the things that you will need to get installed before you actually create your first Angular application. So first one is Node.js. Since Angular is using Node.js on the backend, we need to install that one. So pretty much just go to this website, nodejs.org/n/download, and choose the operating system that you have, architecture that you have, and download the installer for it. And once you get that part done, you can easily verify by opening, if you are on the Windows, you can open command prompt like I do here, and then you can just say npm-v or --v, and then if you get the version that you currently installed, that means that you have the Node.js installed. Next one is Angular command line interface, which means we are going to use this tool a lot, so for that reason you can install it by running this command here. And again, on Windows, you can use it, do it to the command prompt, or if you are, let's say, on the Linux, you can use terminal, etc. And finally, what you need to have is some kind of text editor. It can be Visual Studio, Sublime Text, PHP Storm, or any other that you prefer. So now that we have everything that we need, let's create our first Angular application. So my text editor of choice is PHP Storm. I use it for everything. And in that one, I already have integrated the terminal, which is pretty much like command prompt. And from here, I have already created some folder and open it. So let's now create the first project. So how we are going to do it, I'm going to say ng new, and then we're just going to give it some name. So I'll just say hello world, hit enter, and let's just wait for a couple of the seconds to finish. So for now, I don't need routing, and I'm going to use CSS. So let's wait for it. So now when the installation has been finished, let's now click here, and soon we should get the list of all the files that have been created. So just give it some time, and boom, here it is. So from here, you can see that I have a new folder that's called Hello World. So what I need first to do before I want to run this one is I will need to position myself inside of it. So I will just say cd, which is change directory to the Hello World. And now from here, I will be able to run my application, and we are going to do it by running ng serve, and then we can specify open, which is not a must, and if I specify, it will instantly open in the new tab of my preferred or default browser this application. So when I hit run, now what will happen behind the scenes, this application will be compiled and new tab in my preferred browser will be opened. So let's just wait for a couple of seconds. Okay, so our application is now running. As you can see, this is the port on which it is working, and this is the first page that has been created. So now, if you want to modify, we can dive deep into the code, and I'm going to explain a couple of things about the structure of Angular application. So here on the source, you are going to see a lot of the different files and everything. So app is pretty much our first component. So this is the main one and only, and also the main of this application. And you can see a couple of the files here. In the future videos, we are going to talk much longer and in more details about those. But for now, say that we have file that is going to contain only the CSS, the next one is only for the HTML, this is one for the testing, then we have the code behind or JavaScript code that is going to run our entire component. Each component have one, it specifies with the component, and we need to specify some object that will have selector, template URL, which is where our HTML code will be, and style URLs, which is where our CSS will be. So if we open our HTML, you will be able to see that here they have provided a lot of the code, which is pretty much a template that we can use, but obviously we can easily also delete it and say something like title. And now it might be interesting for you, so where did I get this title from? It is declared here, so that means that this is pretty much like data binding in action. So you can see that from view, I am accessing the variable inside of the code, and now you will see that it's instantly compiled. And if we open our browser, you'll be able to see it. So now if I go here and change it to whatever, let's say just add, and hit save, again, same thing happen. And if I go back, you will see it in action. And pretty much for now, that's all that you need to do. You can play around and experiment a little bit, but in the future tutorials, we are going a lot more deeper. We are going to talk about other things, and you are going even to create some big projects using the Angular. So I hope so that this is super exciting for you and that you can't wait the next tutorials. And if this content is something that might interest you, please consider subscribing.